So, okay, here we have a 4x4 matrix with its inverse almost completed. There are two entries missing in the first row, and then one in second, third, and fourth row each. It is not difficult to check that the determinant of this matrix is 11, so actually this entry here is coming straight from definition, which means this is the matrix of cofactors, transposed matrix of cofactors. So all we have to do is find 5 cofactors. The one thing you have to pay attention to is that in the definition or in the formula for the inverse, the matrix is transposed. So in this entry, when you have an entry with the first row, second column, so it's 1, 2, we actually have to compute the cofactor C2, 1, right? You have to reverse or switch the row and column in the transpose. And now we go by definition. It's a negative 1 to power 3. 2 plus 1 is 3, so it's actually a negative. And remove second row, first column. You get a submatrix like this. Now we could go either by Laplace expansion or the rule of Sarrus, whichever is your pleasure. I'll go by the rule. So we have a product of the diagonals, top left to bottom right, which is 1 plus 1, then minus the product of the other diagonals, right, from the bottom left to top right. And we get negative 3. So we can fill it in now. The negative 3 is a C21, the cofactor C21, so it goes in the position 1, 2, right here. Right. The next is first row, third column, which means C31. Okay, 3 plus 1 is a 4, so we have a plus. Remove third row, first column. Copy the submatrix. Okay, and again by the rule of Sarrus, we have what? 0 plus 0 minus 2, and then minus the product on the other diagonals, which is just minus 1 minus 4, and that's negative 7. We can fill it in the position 1, 3. Okay, 3 more to go. The next one is easy because it's second row, second column, so it's simply C2, 2. No switching needed here. Okay, 2 plus 2 is 4, so it's a plus. And remove second row, second column. Okay, again, either the rule of Sarrus or Laplace expansion, whichever you prefer. And we get 5, which means we can fill it in the position 2, 2. Okay, now third row, first column, which means C1, 3, right? We reverse the order again because it's a transpose. 1 plus 3 is a 4, so it's a plus. Remove first row, third column from the matrix A, of course. Copy the remaining submatrix. And now, again, simple arithmetic. That's a 3. And fill it in. Okay, one last one to go. Fourth row, third column, so C3, 4. Right there. 3 plus 4 is 7, so it's a minus. And third row, fourth column, go away. Whatever remains is gonna give us our determinant. And that's simply negative, because we have a negative in front of the cofactor, 2 minus 1, and then minus the other diagonals, which is a 2 and a 3, altogether a 4. Fill in the last blank, and there is the completed inverse matrix.